I'm walking out of the club. It's a rough place to be at the wrong place at the wrong time. We walking out of this club, this altercation breaks out. There's a bunch of people out there, these fighting break out. My limo is the only limo that's sitting in front of this club, fighting everywhere, 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 everywhere. Then gunshots ring. 14 gunshots hit the side of my limo. We drove off. We got back to the hotel. And the message was on the news, we are looking for a black limousine navigator in connection to a double homicide. Two men were brutally stabbed today. Wow. I was definitely accused of double murder. I was falsely accused of double murder, actually. And they arrested me that morning in front of all three of my sons, which is the hardest thing to ever do, is to fight for your freedom in front of your family. And the first night I was in jail, a whisper came to my ear, and it said, can you hear me now? And that's the only time, the real time, that I heard God that clearly. I'm always disturbed in my spirit on how people look at me from that instance, because those families that was affected will never know the truth. And that's sad. They still didn't find the people who done that. They never had an ounce of evidence of this. And that's when I knew, no matter where I was, no matter how low I had been in my life, by any means necessary, I will prove, not just to myself, to my family, to my children, to my fans, I gotta get something done. Because if y'all that bold to put my reputation on the line, then I'm as bold as you are to fight for it. We done been here 3 years in a row, and we let this team off the hook. Make sure something tonight ain't taking you away from this moment, man. Because that's all we got. That's what y'all don't realize most of the time. We don't get this again. We don't get this again. The clock runs too fast. That's why we got to savor these moments. Because they right now. I couldn't understand that when I was 24 and 25. That's why God had to incarcerate me so I could see how great my blessing was that he had for me. So I had to come from a jail cell being in position to then step on a Super Bowl podium, man. I don't do this for me. I watch enough film so I can put myself in position to make my defense the best defense in damn football. That's why I come back every year.
I'm trying to tell y'all, God has never made a mistake. He's never made one mistake. All right, so it ain't about one play, it ain't about nothing. This year, we did what we were supposed to do. We fought as a team. We fought as a team. There will be one Super Bowl champ crowned at the end of this year. That's it. So the way we feel, somebody gonna feel like that tomorrow, and somebody gonna feel like that in a week. That's a fact. And the fact is, we gotta come back and go to work to make sure we finish it next time. That's all we gotta do. Joe, you played your ass off. You hear me, man? I'm telling you, man. Don't ever drop your head when it comes to a loss, dog. Because there's too much pain outside of this that people really going through. This right here makes us strong. Let's understand who we are as a team. Let's understand who we are as men. And let's make somebody smile when we walk out of here. We got an opportunity to keep going, man. Let's be stronger as a team, man. Let's be who we are. Ravens on three. 1, 2, 3,
Ravens! Let me tell you something. If tomorrow wasn't promised, what would you give for today? Forget everything else. Forget everything else. Forget that there was any sunlight left. What would you spend today thinking about? Yourself? Or the man that's beside you? Or the man that you know you'll give everything in your heart for? we get one opportunity in life, one chance in life, to do whatever you're gonna do, to lay your foundation, to make whatever mark you're gonna make, whatever legacy you're gonna leave, leave your legacy. And it's found through effort. Wins and losses come a dime a dozen. But effort, nobody can judge effort. Because effort is between you and you. Effort ain't got nothing to do with nobody else. So that team that think they ready to see you, they think what they seen on film, they ain't saw what film shows. Because every day is a new day. Every moment is a new moment. So now you got to go out and show them that I'm a different creature now than I was 5 minutes ago. Because I'm pissed off for greatness. Because if you ain't pissed off for greatness, that means you okay with being mediocre. Ain't no man in here okay with being just basic. So let's do what we do. Yeah. Tonight,
sir.
We ain't got to worry about taking no breaks. Don't worry about taking no breaks.
It's called a bull rush. A football defender explodes forward, ready to obliterate anyone standing between him and the ball carrier. He's like a human battering ram. Which got us thinking, is he really like a battering ram? Does an NFL linebacker's bull rush pack as much force as an actual battering ram?
To answer that question, we loaded up our science hardware and headed to the outdoor testing facility. And we recruited one of the best defensive players of all time, All-Pro NFL linebacker, Ray Lewis. Lewis is simply one of the most dominant players in the game. And he loves to obliterate opponents with the bull rush.
A bull rush is taking a man's will and saying, I can deal with you any way I feel like dealing with you. I'm gonna put my helmet right up under your chin, I'm gonna put my hands right up under your shoulder pads, and I'm gonna push you as hard as I can to make sure I can get you out of the way. So I've already made up in my mind that anything's in front of me, I'm destroying it. That's when football and science comes together for real.
For this test, Ray Lewis is going up against an all-star in his own field, veteran SWAT team leader, Lee Waddell. This law enforcement tough guy has tracked down and apprehended thousands of dangerous criminals. Ray and Lee will each take on the same unforgiving opponent, a solid wooden door. This is a standard front door, 2 inches thick, and we've added extra bracing, heavy screws, and a chain lock to make sure the door provides maximum resistance.
This door is not some prop door. This is a regular front door, like the door on your house. I mean, it's on there. I mean, it's solid.
And our scientists have attached a load cell to the door. This high-tech sensor will record exactly how many pounds of force our linebacker and our SWAT officer deliver when they come a-knockin'.
So what do you have that you're gonna use to get through the door?
What we're gonna use is we have a 15-pound battering ram here, pretty standard. We use this to breach a lot of doors. This is what we go through all the time.
And we're gonna see who wins, the battering ram or the bull rush.
Let's do it.
All right.
Thank you. It was good impact. See where it hit right on the sensor. So that'll give us some really good numbers.
So how much force did the battering ram generate? The load cell reveals it smashed the door with 800 pounds of force. That's like butting heads with a real ram. From only 2 feet away, the 15-pound ram accelerates rapidly, up to almost 20 miles an hour. And all of that energy is focused on the small 3-inch end. Since an NFL player can't move that fast and can't deliver a hit with such a concentrated contact area, football's bull rush shouldn't be able to generate as much force as this battering ram. But if anyone's up to the challenge, it's Ray Lewis.
So what we've done is we've rigged up a door with a pressure plate in it to see exactly how much force you apply when you're bull rushing the line. If you look at this, I mean, this is a real door. I mean, you gotta really hit this thing.
All right, let's do it.
Let's do it, man.
Science meets Ray Lewis.
Getting through a door this solid is no joke. If Ray hits the door wrong, the energy he creates will reflect right back at him.
Sports science, open up.
Here we go. Is this for real? 3, 2, 1, go! Oh my God, look at the door!
Yeah?
Look at the door!
No, you don't realize until you look at it yourself, man. This door is sharp. This is a real door.
Ray didn't just break through the bolted knob and the chain lock. He ripped out over a dozen 3-inch screws from the door frame and completely sheared off all the hinges.
This is freaking incredible, man. I'm gonna call my mom in a minute.
So how much force did Ray generate? Our motion capture technology gives us an inside look. The key equation here is force equals mass times acceleration. Ray weighs 15 times more than the battering ram. And by lowering his center of gravity 1 foot, and accelerating up to 6 G's. Amazingly, Ray generates over 1,000 pounds of force. That's 200 more pounds of bone-crushing force than the battering ram. And the only reason Ray doesn't break bones every time he hits someone is because shoulder pads decrease the force by 50%. And the rib cage is made to flex up to 2.5 inches. But even with these factors, when you get hit by a Ray Lewis bull rush, it'll still feel like you're getting trampled by a real raging bull. That's how Ray Lewis uses physics to blow someone's doors off.
Science meets Ray Lewis and science loses again. I'll argue with critics. Hey, awesome. Ray Lewis losing step. They praise quarterbacks for the legacy on how long they've been able to keep offenses consistent for so long. How long has the Ravens defense been in the top 5? And they left one thing here. 52.
the most consistent thing the Ravens has ever had.
I'm armed till I'm on an island. My life's riding on an autobahn, on autopilot. Before I touch dirt, I'll kill y'all with kindness. I kill ya, my natural persona is much worse. You've been warned if you've been born or if you conform. Slap up a cop and then snatch him out of his uniform. Leave him with socks, hard bottoms, and bloomers on. And hang him by his balls from the horn of a unicorn. Y'all niggas intellect mad slow, y'all fags know. Claiming you banging, you flaming. Bet you could light your own cigarette with your asshole. Me and Shady dead at the past, so that basically resurrected my cash flow. I might rap tight as the snatch of a fat dyke, though I ain't rap tight. My blood type's the 80s. My 90s was like the Navy, you was like the Brady's. You still fly kites daily.
Catch me in my Mercedes, bumping ice ice, baby, screaming shady till I die. Like I have a paradise, life's crazy, so I live it to the fullest till I'm Swayze. And you only live it once, so I'm thinking about this nice, nice land. Wait, don't stop me now before I get on a roll. Let me tell you what this pretty little dame's name is, cause she's kind of famous. And I hope that I don't sound too heinous when I say this. Nicki Minaj, what I wanna stick my penis in your anus. You more stick that I'm a genius. Really, I belong inside a dang insane asylum. Can't try them trailer parks crazy. I am back and I am razor sharp. Baby in this back with a capital B with an exclamation mark. Maybe you should listen when I put the linguistics. Cause when I rip this mystical slick shit, you don't wanna become another victim of statistic of this shit. Cause after I spit the bullets, I'ma treat these shell cakes like a soccer ball. I'ma kick the ballistics, so get this dick, I'ma lift this.
Life in the fast lane, moving at the speed of life and I can't slow down. Only got a gallon in the gas tank, but I'm almost at the finish line, so I can't stop now. I don't really know where I'm headed, cause I'm enjoying the ride. Don't roll till I drop, don't ride till I die.
To be relaxed in orbit, at war with a bottle as Captain Morgan attacks my organs. My slow flow is euphoric, it's like I rap endorphins. I made a pact with the devil that says I'll let you take me. You let me take a shovel, dig up the corpse of Jack of Orkin. Go back and forfeit, more beef than you can pack a fork in. I'm living the life of the infinite enemy down. My tenement chimney now, the semi-serenity pal. Spin them around, entering in the vicinity.
Now, it's called him and then, but he threw it a canning and ate the rap. I chewed him up and spitted him out. Girl, get it up, now get down. He's looking around, it's clubbing, it looks like people are having a shit pick now. Yeah, little trailer trash, take a look who's back and tip the town. Did a sister start a motherfucker? Fuck them all, he's just a whole motherfucking wall. I'll get it down every time he comes, I'll flip it round. And he came to the club tonight with 5'9 to hold this bitch down. Like a motherfucking chick in the water, he's trying to drink to drown. Shorty, when you dance, you got me captivated. Just by the way that you keep licking them dicks like a lips, I'm agitated, aggravated. To the point you don't suck my dick, then you're gonna get decapitated. Other words, you don't fucking give me head, then I'ma have to take
and
it.
And after taking that, I'ma catch your case, it's gonna be fascinating. This gon' say the whole rap game passed away on top of the affidavit. Activator, meaning I'm on fire off the top. Might run a back up data. Rolling over hip hop in a verbal tractor trailer. Homie, they sick. You can normally ask a hater. Don't it make sense? It's these shell cases. It's just like a bag of paper dropped in the lap of a tax evader. Homie, they spit.
And I make that ass drop like a sack of potatoes. What girl on the cracker later? Percolator, this party. Be my penis ejaculator later. Tell your boyfriend that you just struck pay. That you're rolling with a player. You won't be exaggerating when you say you're living
life in the fast lane. Moving at the speed of life, and I can't slow down.